Welcome students. Today we are going to start with the next exercise, that is how to find out the factors of a quadratic equation. So there are different methods of finding out the roots of the quadratic equation. So the first method is factorization method. So this factorization method, you are learnt in the 8th standard, you are learnt in 9th standard how to find out the factors of a trinomial expression. So to find out the roots of the quadratic equation, you have to factorize the equation, equate it to zero, and then find out what are the roots. So practice set 2.2. You have got the first one, x square minus 15x plus 54 is equal to zero. So this is a quadratic equation. So this you have to find out the roots of this quadratic equation by factorization method. The first method is a factorization method. So learn the method by its name. So it is called as a factorization method. So now here you have got three terms. You are going to take the product of the first and the last. So where you have got 54, find the factors of 54 such that by adding the two equations or by subtraction you have to get the middle term. So here the factors are 9 and 6. 9, 6 are 54. So here signs, how you are going to give the signs? By adding the two expressions you have got the middle term. So give the same signs to both of it. So this can be written as, so that is x square minus 9x minus 6x plus 54 equate to, so this much you already learnt in how to find the factors in 9th standard. Only you have got an extra step, you are equating to 0 and finding out what are the values of x, which are nothing but the roots of the equation. Now here grouping the first two, you get x minus 9. In grouping the next two, minus 6 is taken out as common. So you'll get this as x minus 9 equated to 0. So you get this as x minus 9 into x minus 6 equal to 0. So from product of two terms is equal to 0, which means that either the first one should be equal to 0 or the second one should be equal to 0. So you're equating both of it to 0 and getting the values of x. So that is x minus 9 is equal to 0, or you get x minus 6 is equal to 0. So from this you have to find out what are the values of x. So therefore the values of take 9 to the other side, you get x is equal to 9, or you get x is equal to take 6 to the other side. So x is equal to 9 or x is equal to 3 are the 6 are the roots of the equation. Therefore 9 or x is equal to 6 are the roots of the equation. So like this you have to, so till here you have already learned. The next two only you are adding another 2-3 steps to that, equating it to 0 and finding out what are the values of x. Third one, 2y square plus 27y plus 13 equal to 0. So here taking the product of the first and the last, you are getting 26. Factors for this are 26 and 1, and 26 plus 1 is 27. So you get this as 2y square plus 26y plus 1y plus 13 equal to 0. Grouping it, you will get 2y is common, so you will get it as y plus 13, 1 is common, y plus 13 equal to 0. So from this what you get here is y plus 13 into 2y plus 1 equal to 0. So the next step, equate each of it to 0, you get y plus 13 is equal to 0 or 2y plus 1 equal to 0. From this, what you get y is equal to minus 13. Take 13 to the other side, or you get y is equal to first take minus 1 to the other side. You'll get minus 1. Then bring 2 to the denominator. You get it as minus 1 upon 2. Therefore, y is equal to minus 13, or y is equal to minus 1 upon 2 are the roots of the equation. The seventh problem, you got 6x minus 2 upon x is equal to 1. So this, as it is not in the standard form. So first multiply throughout by x and get it the standard form. You got x in the denominator. So each and every term multiply by x. Multiply by x. So what you get? 6x square minus 2 is equal to x. Rearrange it and write it as 6x square minus x minus 2 equal to 0. So you have got the standard form of the quadratic equation. Now what you have to do is find out what are the factors. Taking product, you get minus 12, 4 and 3. 4 threes are 12. Here you have got minus, so this will be minus and this will be plus. So you get this as 6x square minus 4x plus. So take a rearrange and write it as, first we'll write it as 3x because you can take out 3 as common. Anyway you do it, you'll get the same answer. Plus 3x minus 4x minus 2 equal to 0. So grouping it, you get 3x is common, we'll be left with x plus 1. Here minus 2 is common, we get 2x. 3 2's are, so you get this as a 2x. Here 2 is taken out as common, minus 2, so you'll get 2x. Since minus is taken, you need to change the sign of this, you get plus 1 equal to 0. So you get 2x plus 1 into 3x minus 2 equal to 0. So from this you get either 2x plus 1 equal to 0 or 3x minus 2 equal to 0. From this the value of x is equal to minus 1 upon 2, or x is equal to, and this goes to the other side, 2 and bring 3, so you get 2 upon 3. And you write the final statement, therefore minus 1 upon 2 and 2 upon 3 are the roots of the equation. Even this way you can write the answer. Roots of the equation. Seventh problem, root 2 x square plus 7x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0. So here it is in the third form. Method of doing it is the same. So first we will multiply this one. You will get 5 root 2 into root 2. 5 root 2 into root 2 it is. So you get 5 into 2 which is equal to 10. So factors for 10 are 5 and 2, and 5 plus 2 is 7 you are getting. So you get this as root 2 x square plus 5x plus 2x plus 5 root 2 is equal to 0. So next is you are grouping it. Now when you are grouping it, here you have got root, but you don't have root here. So only x is common, so take out x as a common factor. So when you take x as common factor, then here you will be left with root 2x plus 5. Now when you come to the second equation, here as it is, when you look at the equation, you cannot take anything as common factor. So what you do is, since you have got root 2 here, express this 2 also in terms of a root. So 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. Root 2 into root 2 is nothing but 2. So split this one in terms of thirds. Now you have got root 2 into root 2 x and 5 root 2. Now when you look at these two equations, now root 2 is common. So when root 2 is taken, 1 root 2 is taken out as common, we will be left with root 2 into x. And here root is taken out, so you will be left with the 5. Now next you have got root 2 x plus 5. And you have got x plus root 2 equal to 0. Now equating it, you get root 2 x plus 5 is equal to 0. Or x plus root 2 equal to 0. So from this you get x is equal to, when 5 goes to the other side, minus 5 upon root 2, or you get x is equal to minus root 2. Then you write the final answer. Therefore minus 5 upon root 2 and minus root 2 are the roots of the equation. So this completes the problem. I got the 10th problem. 25 m square is equal to 9. So this you have to do it by factorization method. So first what you have to do is 25 m square, bring 9 to the other side. Now next we express this as a 5m whole square. Square root of 25 is 5, so I express it as 5m whole square. Square root of 9 is 3, write it as 3 square. So when you simplify it, this when you square it, you will get this. When you square this one, you are getting 9. Now this is in the form of a square minus b square. So a square minus b square, the formula is a plus b into a minus b. So use that formula and write this as a 5m plus 3 into 5m minus 3 equal to 0. Now you have got the factors, you have expressed this as factors of two numbers. Now you write the values of m. 5m plus 3 is equal to 0, or you get 5m minus 3 equal to 0. So from this the value of m is equal to minus 3 upon 5, or you get the value of m is equal to plus 3 upon 5. So therefore minus 3 upon 5 and 3 upon 5 are the roots. So this one, bring it to the other side, you get this as 7m square minus 21m equal to 0. Take out what is common. 7m is common. We will be left with m minus 3. So you have got product of two numbers, factors you expressed it. From this, 7m is equal to 0, or m minus 3 equal to 0. From this you get m is equal to 0. 0 upon 7 is 0. Or you get m is equal to, take 3 to the other side, you will get 3. Then you write, so m is equal to 0 and m is equal to 3 are the roots of the equation. So now suppose if you have got one more problem, m square minus 11 equal to 0. So this is not in the perfect square form. So you have to write this as m square minus, if you don't have a perfect square. In the previous problem when you did, 9 was a perfect square number, so you wrote it as 3 square. If it is not a perfect square, express that as root of the number and write it as whole square. So equal to 0. Now this is the form of a square minus b square, where you have to use a plus b into a minus b. So you get m plus root 11 into m minus root 11 equal to 0. So from this what you get, m plus root 11 equal to 0, or m minus root 11 equal to 0. So from this, value of m is equal to minus root 11, or m is equal to plus root 11. So this is how you work out the problem when it is not a perfect square number.